Hello, in this video I am going to be discuss about types of corrosion. So various types of corrosions are listed here: uniform corrosion, pitting corrosion, intergranular corrosion, stress corrosion, season corrosion, crevice corrosion, fatigue corrosion, erosion corrosion, atmospheric corrosion, underground corrosion, fretting corrosion, and selective corrosion. Now let us see in detail of each corrosion. First is uniform corrosion. The rate of corrosion is uniform. Okay, metal or alloy is completely homogeneous. As a result of this, the galvanic cell are established between any two points on the metal surface in the presence of acids or alkalines. So in the homogeneous material, throughout the material is eroded or corrosion take place on the surface. Okay, so this type of corrosion is known as uniform corrosion. Pitting corrosion. This type of corrosion takes place at particular point like pinhole, thus forming a cavity on the metal surface. Pitting corrosion occurs more commonly in tubes, pipes, and vessels due to breakdown or cracking on the protective film on the metal surface. Okay, so in the metal, if there is one crack, so the corrosion takes place at that particular crack or different dots and the cavity of the pitting where the corrosion is take place. This type of corrosion is known as pitting corrosion. Intergranular corrosion, which occurs along grain boundaries of the metal, sensitive to corrosive attack. The intergranular corrosion generally occurs if the grain boundaries contain material which shows a solution potential more anodic than that the grain center in the particular corroding medium. This potential difference may be either due to difference in grain orientations or precipitation in grain boundaries. So if you see the internal structure of the metal, there are different grains are there, and at the each grain boundaries the corrosion take place. That type of corrosion is known as intergranular corrosion. Stress corrosion. It is a type of corrosion which occurs in internally stressed engineering components used in corrosive environments. The stress corrosion failures evolves high residual stresses which may result from precipitation and phase transformation, unequal cooling, cold working, and welding components. So you can see in this image the stress corrosion. Season corrosion. It is a type of corrosion which occurs in brass, especially in the presence of moisture and traces of ammonia. It has been observed that pure copper is not susceptible to stress corrosion, but small amount of alloying elements such as zinc, aluminium, silicon, antimony, arsenic, and phosphorus results in marked sensitivity to intergranular attacks. So this type of corrosion occurs mostly in brass material. Okay. Crevice corrosion. It is a type of corrosion which occurs in cracks or crevices formed between matching surface metal assemblies and takes the form of pitting or etched patches. The matting surface may be of similar metal, a metal, and a non-metal or dissimilar metals. Crevice corrosion may also occurs under scale and surface deposits under loose fitting washers and gaskets. Fatigue corrosion. It is a type of corrosion due to cyclic stresses. It generally takes place by the propagation of transcrystalline cracks, which occurs on nearly all materials and almost any corrosive liquid under the effect of cyclic stresses. So generally the shafts and some rotating parts where continuously compressive and tensile stress are developed. So due to that fatigue, the corrosion takes place. Erosion corrosion, which is caused by the combined effect of erosion by turbulent flow of gases or liquids and the rubbing of solids over a metal surface. The corrosion occurs more commonly in piping, agitators, condenser tubes, and in such vessel in which stream of liquid or gases emerge from an opening and strikes the sidewall at very high velocities. So generally it happens when the liquids and gases are flowing through the pipes. Atmospheric corrosion. It is a type of corrosion which occurs either due to oxide film formation or due to the film breakdown on the metal surface. The factors which greatly affect the atmospheric corrosion are the humidity, presence of impurities in the atmosphere, nature of corrosion products, and the presence of suspended panicles in the atmosphere. The atmospheric corrosion is very severe in ferrous metals. Underground corrosion. It is a type of corrosion which occurs in the pipes buried under the earth surface. The underground corrosion depends upon the corrosive nature of the soil and may cause serious damage to materials unless more protective measures are taken. So this type of corrosion is seen in the pipes which are underground. So due to the sand and other particles, the surface of the pipe is corroded. Fretting corrosion. It is a type of corrosion which occurs in situations where there is slight relative movement of contacting surfaces due to the action of the alternating loads. The fretting corrosion occurs more frequently in bolted joints and other fitted assemblies. If protective films are broken, the bare metal is exposed. This leads to more oxidation. This effect produces localized pitting, which may become the source of fatigue cracks. So in the race of the bearing, it is continuously rotating on the shaft. So this surface is eroded, okay, which is known as fretting corrosion. And the last is selective corrosion. It is a type of corrosion which occurs in alloys in which one component is removed selectively, leaving behind the other with the help of corrosive medium. The selective corrosion is generally found in marine boilers. The marine boilers used condenser tubes made of brass with high content of zinc. The process of losing zinc from the condenser tube is called de-zincification. So this type of corrosion is generally seen in below sea level, okay, in underwater. So the machines and some part of the boat and ships will be eroded or corroded by de-zincification. So this type of corrosion is known as selective corrosion. Thank you for watching this video.